Hey everybody, thanks for watching. I'm out here in Duarte, Rancho Duarte Golf Course with Lee Deitrick, a friend of mine and golf instructor for the last, how many years have you been teaching golf, Lee?
37.
37 years. Wealth of knowledge about the game of golf, also teaches at the Professional Golfers Career College in Temecula?
Yep.
That's right. So Lee and I, in our last video, we were talking about, mostly it was about the differences in the modern meaning like 2017 swing, versus before, which was only like, it's changed already in 10 years. So, and golf is 500 years old. So it's, but one of the things that comes with all these changes kind of, Lee, and a lot of amateurs, myself included, from the top, we see this a lot. So you guys, if you guys been following my swing changes, you see that I have a real case of wanting, I feel in my body that this is going to hit the ball hard. When somebody comes with you and you see this move a lot, which then also translates to that, what's some of your checklists to go through to start changing that?
Well, what I think happens is this. If you go to the top where you are up there, well, if stand the other way.
This way?
Yeah.
Okay.
As you go up top, what's happening is you're out of sequence. Mm-hmm. You're working the top and you want to be working the bottom a little more.
Okay.
So what I would have you feel like, what I did with you, I had you feel like you were singing Happy Gilmore. So I want you to feel pressure going into this foot.
First.
Yeah. And now as you do that, just let this fall. I mean, you don't need to open it up a bunch. Just let it fall. So there's your motion. You follow that?
Mm-hmm.
So if I had you on video, which we kind of did, take your setup there a minute.
Okay.
Come back to your impact alignment. Go to impact. So this would be my playing through impact.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now go to the top. Okay, now this shaft, what I'd like to see is this shaft pretty close to the same angle.
Okay.
Okay? So if I was drawing online, I can draw an angle like you were at a dress, which would be probably where the elbow plane is. And this would be there. So what you want to do is I want to move this club down so it comes down to that same angle.
Okay.
So it's right here. So I'm coming in on that same angle I was that I started.
Yeah.
Basically, the angle's the same, but it's almost like they're parallel.
Yeah.
You follow me? So I got an angle here I started on, and because you bent your elbow a little bit, that shaft has gone up. Now, the minute you start back to the ball, that elbow is going to open, and your hands are going to lower, and so is the center of mass of the club, which is about right there, going to lower.
Yeah.
And that's going to bring you down to where you're right about in that place I was in the last video where you're above your toe stance line and you're parallel and your body will be a little bit open and now you can just rotate, come here and come all the way through as you go through.
Yeah, I think that's really the key to being a repeatable striker is to be able to get to a really good P6 as I call it and then not really have to do very much at all.
No, go back up top. So you're here. Okay, now, so you're gonna move the pressure from this foot to this foot. And just go back. Just step on this foot. There. Now let your arms fall as you go. So if you don't let your arms fall, step. You see what's happening? You haven't let that elbow fall, and now you're starting to go like that.
Yeah.
So you want to get this to go here. So this is gonna step. That's gonna fall.
Yeah.
And then you would continue to let this move. Now you're back to parallel and horizontal.
And at that point, after I've done that, that's when I can start rotating?
Yeah, you can just go.
Okay.
But you can't rotate before you get the weight there. That's like I had you do, that's why I had you when we talked, do Happy Gilmore, because I wanted you to feel, I wanted you to go here and not to shift over there, but to plant that and then rotate.
Yeah, Tony talks about a place kicker.
Yeah.
You're gonna...
You plant and then you go.
Yeah.
You plant. Mm-hmm. That's an excellent analogy. Another good analogy.
Yeah.
But everybody's trying to go here.
Yeah.
And then they feel like they get stuck because now the club is going to go
this way.
Feels
like everything's back here. Yeah.
Yeah. And see, I think what happens is that in terms of a plane, I'd rather not see a lot of movement. I'd rather see it be simple. Okay?
Yep.
Like the Fury can get it done that way. Sam Snead brought it in and then went out this way. But I like to keep things as close to being on plane as I can. So what that would mean would be, I would be here, this goes up to the top, it's at an angle about like that, now that angle comes back down, it's almost the same angle. Now it's higher, because my elbow's bent.
Yeah.
The reason, once I start bending this elbow, this is up in the air, but this shaft is still pointing down toward relatively close to where the ball was. Now here's three opinions on how this works. The golfing machine, we would want the butt of the club to point to the gutter.
At which point in position?
Well, it's going to trace it all the way. If I had a laser, it would point. Now it's parallel.
Now it's a repoint.
Now this is going to point. The butt end points. Now the butt end points to here. Now the tip end points. That's a golf machine. Mm-hmm. Haney would have you be on a parallel plane.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So he would take you back like this. At the top of the backswing, you'd be at the same angle you were when you started, but you'd maybe point out to here.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Shifting planes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ledbetter.
Yeah.
Ledbetter.
A-swing.
Would have you go back to here, and he'd keep you more, he wouldn't have you point there or a little bit out. He'd want you to point somewhere in this area here.
Is Lydia Ko in the A-swing.
Yeah. You're going here, and then he would flatten this out to come back down like that.
Yeah.
But I think, and this is what Brian was talking about this morning in the show that I watched, that when you bring this down, you're not holding this like this. You're going to let this form, this elbow open to get down to here, and then I'm going to go through. Most people think this is lag. Mm-hmm. Lag is simply this right wrist being there. Lag is not this wrist cock angle.
Yeah.
Lag is more this right wrist bent angle coming through.
Yeah, you see so many great players at position six have this really good, Dustin Johnson, Rory, a lot of guys,
rotate.
This really good angle here, and you see so many of us are more like that.
Yeah. Here, so you do.
The best way that I've found in the Be a Better Golf experience to keep that is not by, the more I tried to hold this, the more I'd let it out. And the more I tried to let it all out, the more actually I would get this.
Exactly.
Which is totally backwards.
That in amongst itself is Peter Croker.
Okay, yeah.
That's Peter Croker's, that's a gist of what Peter wanted you to do with the thing.
That's Monty's no turning cast.
Yeah, so you go back up here. So what you need to learn to do, I get you back, because this is, again, my preference, because you don't go back with the shafts horizontal, I get the shaft over here at the top.
Yeah.
I would tend to have you feel more like you're like that. Now, as you come down, let your right arm straighten.
Okay.
So in the golf machine,
That's different than what I do.
Hold on. In the golfing machine, one of the things that's in there you don't find anywhere else is how to keep this arm straight. Mm-hmm. You use it by pushing your left arm.
You don't do it with left arm tension. You do it with extension.
Here's what I want you to do. Mm-hmm. I want you to feel like you're pushing down. I don't want you to jam it. I just want you to feel down. Mm-hmm. Okay, now.
I'm sorry, down or towards the ball down?
No, you're going to go down this way. You're going to go under the shaft.
Yep.
Right there. Now, you got a little bit of pressure right there. Mm-hmm. Now, take her back. You feel that pressure?
Yeah, definitely.
Still there. Now, as you start down under this foot, now there's a natural unfolding of this elbow. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It happens automatically. If somebody wants to do this at home, they put on a sweatshirt.
Yep.
Don't put the left arm in the sleeve. I can't get this in and out of there, but that's, or a windbreaker and hold the sleeve.
Yeah, we see Mike Austin do this.
And you're going to hold this like this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're going to hold it like that. And what happens is as you come down here, you don't have to try to open this elbow up. It's going to open.
Yeah.
Well, because you're moving the arms in front of your body again. Yeah, it's got to be almost like, I remember Seve saying something in one of his books. It's almost like it's a free fall.
Okay.
I mean, it's like this. Put your hands on my shoulders. Now, just rest your hands there. So all the weight is on my shoulders.
Yeah.
Right there. You got them there?
Got them.
Yeah. So when I come back, they should fall.
Oh, yeah. Until I stop them, yeah.
they should feel like that.
Yeah.
Well, that's what it should feel like as you're starting down. You shouldn't have that tension up in your armpits up here. You're going to have tension there. You're going to have connection, but you don't have tension holding them in where you're tight.
I found for me that took an almost insane amount of patience to just stay there and let it fall, especially when I got under pressure. Like when I'm at the top, I want to start doing something. You know what I mean? So like for me to go like this and then do something was really, really difficult. So how do people do that without fighting this impulse to just, you know, because if I go to actually hit this.
Okay, let me try to answer that question. start over there and show me Happy Gilmore. No, no, you're coming this way. So the the camera can see face on.
Yep.
Just
do
walk
Happy
a couple
Gilmore.
Spaces and just go. Okay. You don't need to hit it hard. Just go. You plant, then you turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah. So you plant, turn.
Yeah.
Plant, turn.
Uh-huh.
So the only reason I'm using that is to get the plant.
Let's
I want
try that
the
one
plant.
More time.
And when you did that, you didn't move your arms out when you did that. And when we watched the video, it didn't go out.
Well, let's see down this way.
Because you felt like you were going to swing a little bit low to high, like you're skipping a rock, or like you're going to go sidearm and underhanded when you're going that way.
Well, there's really no thought at all. I mean,
it's
the ideal,
exactly.
I'm just doing it.
So here's the next thing I would do. I'd pretend I have 5 or 6 balls in a row.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's do
grab
it.
I'm not going to hit them.
We can line
them
up.
Give me 2 more, or 3 more. Put one there, and put one. That's good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the people walking, and I went to the Happy Gilmore because this was too hard for most people.
Okay.
For whatever reason, I didn't think it would, but it was. So I get to swinging back and forth, and then I walk and I plant. So I'm getting that feeling of that motion. You do.
Yeah, Mr. Martin Hall calls this the Yamataki shuffle or something. He has some Japanese lady doing this.
Okay, back
so
up.
So swing in between these balls.
I want you to just get yourself moving. Feeling, so you feel right foot, left foot. Right foot, left foot. Right foot, left foot. Right foot, left foot. So you're planting your weight, and now you're, there's what you want to feel. That's the feeling you want in the ground with your feet.
Okay.
And see, you don't do that because you get up here and your first motion is to go here, and I would want you to feel you're going down from the bottom.
Okay, let's hit a shot.
That's what I'd like to see.
Yeah, let's see how it goes.
So that's the pivot. So what I'm doing is I'm changing the sequence from up here starting to your feet starting. And it didn't always start with me there. That's where it is right now.
Okay.
It's in my feet.
I've always been in kind of my stuff with reactionary golf. I always haven't wanted to have any lower body thoughts because I'm going to be, if I go to the top, I'd be scared of being stuck.
You're afraid you're going to do that, but like what we did 2 nights ago, that didn't happen.
Yeah.
So you want to feel, you want to step on your, so like Kendall would say, it's interesting. Kendall would say, let's step on the right, then step on the left.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he would say, and I would totally agree with that. Go there and then come through.
That's one of Kendall's drills. Somebody on the LPGA does this, he said.
Well, what the girl of the LPGA does is this.
Yeah.
She does this, and this is...
Do you know who he didn't
I'm
going to
send
remember.
It to you. I'll send it to you so you can put the link on your thing.
All right.
It's H-Y-E-Y-O-U-N Kim.
Hyun Kim or something?
Okay. Yeah, and what she does is this. She does this, and she's on YouTube doing this. I mean, she would start right here. She would start right with her feet right here. And she stepped it. She stepped back, and then she stepped forward and hit the ball. That's how she played.
Yeah.
That's how she played.
How she played golf.
That's how she played. That's you see her in a tournament teeing up, hitting the ball like that.
Yeah.
Now, the interesting thing about that, the reason that sequence is so good is if you do the biomechanics and like Dr. Kwan or whatever at the Texas Women's University that you probably heard about and stuff like that, if they go back and analyze that swing and a good downswing, they're almost identical.
In the model. Yeah.
In the model, they're almost identical to what's happening. So she would start here. She'd step back. Then she would move this foot forward.
As that was going back, right.
And go like that. And hit the ball that way. Now, Titleist, when I was growing up years ago,
that is a tough drill to do.
We would go here.
Kendall can flush it that way.
We would go here.
Yeah.
We'd step, and when the club got about right here, we'd step and go through. That's the baseball step drill.
Okay. Show us that again.
Okay. Your baseball step drill was this: you address the ball, bring your left foot over to your right,
mm-hmm.
put the club here, swing back, and then step. So I would step whenever my hands got about right here.
Yeah.
What the TPI has done with that? They've got a baseball step drill plus one, or plus two.
Okay.
They would start here, but instead of starting here, they start over here.
Yep.
And they want more separation.
Okay.
So they're going to go to here. When the club goes past the ball, then you step.
Yeah, I don't like separation. So.
I know, but yeah. That's what you need. But see, you don't like it, but that's what you need to get in the right sequence.
Yeah. Well, one thing I've noticed that you're doing is with that step, it's not a twist and then go. It's just a weight and then everything.
It's pressure into the ground. Uh-huh. It's not something that's happened. Why don't you like the step drills?
Oh, no, step drill I like. But I can't do it very well at all.
Then you practice it until you can do it better.
Yeah.
Where's your tees?
No, I said I didn't like.
Where's your tees?
They're in there in the back pocket.
This one or this one?
That one.
This one?
I think so. I got tees all over the place.
Okay, yeah. Here. Okay, do the old-fashioned step drill.
Okay, the baseball step drill?
Yep. The first, yeah. So get your, address the ball. Mm-hmm. Address it normally. Now bring your left foot over to your right. I'm sorry, left foot over to your right.
Yep.
Put the club here.
On the ground.
On the ground.
Yep.
Now swing your back, step, and hit the ball.
At the same time, swing back and step at the same time?
Just swing back, now step. There's your sequence. And you piped it.
That was a 1 yard draw that went 200 yards, 6 iron. So that's pretty good.
Okay, so what you did is,
that's taking you out of this. If that shoulder is opening,
it's taking
but
you
I
out
imagine
of that.
Not.
You can go back and watch that, but I guarantee it's going to feel different. Go ahead, do it again. So now you're going to swing back and then step.
Clubs on the ground.
Yeah, just step. See, all of a sudden now you're striking the ball.
That was actually even better than the last one.
Okay, now
I'm still watching that ball go.
Well, okay. You can do that. That's a good idea when you practice to watch the ball.
Yeah, right.
Okay, now.
You don't want to reload as soon as impacts happen?
No, here.
Hit and scoop.
Okay, here's what I want you to do. Yeah. Now, step the ball.
I'm pretty good at drills usually.
But then you got to work them into your...
Right, right. Then you got to make
your normal
lead.
Stance. Okay, start the same way. Put your left foot over next to your right. Put the club back here. Mm-hmm. But now what I want you to do is I want you to start here.
All right, so here's the plus one.
This is the plus, whatever. This is the TPI step drill. Now, when the ball gets here, I want you to step.
So?
Yeah.
Okay.
Up, 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 up.
I know. I'm just getting set here.
Okay, now go. That's okay. Do it again.
Couldn't quite get back to the ball.
Don't try to hit it 190. There you go.
Yeah, that was better.
Better? Okay, do something for me. Do something.
Yeah.
Address the ball. Take your stance.
That's me right here.
Okay. I want you to make a slow motion swing where you move 1 inch, maybe you move 2 inches per second.
Yep.
2 inches per second, the whole swing.
Mm-hmm.
Go. That's really pretty damn good. Do it again. Keep going. No, keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Go. You see, that has to go first.
What's that? The weight has to go?
Yeah,
because from here, I'm starting
to twist
already.
You want to go up there. So if you did that slow motion and you went, like if I'm going here, if I'm going like this, when I get up into here, I'm shifting this right away.
So shifting hands, the weight, yeah.
I'm putting the pressure into this front foot so I can move through. But you did it really good. I mean, what you did really good was you did a good slow motion pace. Now do that one more time and do the change of direction.
So a famous video of a 75-year-old Hogan doing this in somebody's backyard.
Well, that's the one where he's hitting the ball
into the water,
Gulf of Mexico.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead. I've seen that. Now take her back. Keep going. Slower. Keep going. Now, right about in this area, you start forward. I want to throw and then let everything turn.
Throw?
Yeah.
What do you mean throw?
Like there's the ball on the ground, I'm going to throw it.
Mm-hmm.
And I try to hit it. Now go. Now throw it. Do it again. You feel the difference?
So.
You're getting in. That's getting
bracing
you.
To,
that's yeah. Now you understand why I liked Happy Gilmore, because that's the motion you get with Happy Gilmore. See, and that's making you, you can still have the aggressiveness in your upper body.
Yeah, I need that.
But you're starting from the ground. You somewhat delayed that.
Uh-huh, yeah. Yeah, it feels pretty good. But you really like that top left foot pressure. How would you use this?
Wait a minute. Top what pressure?
Like left foot stepping. This is something from, I think, Five Simple Keys.
That's the same deal.
Kendall got me. So this is basically a Nerf ball cut in half.
Yeah.
So how would you use this? Because I know Kendall uses it a little differently than the Chuck and those guys do.
Well, I would just set it. You're here. You're there.
Squish.
I just want to feel. I mean, I don't need that.
Yeah.
Because I'm here, and this foot is feeling like it's turning like that.
Okay.
To wind me up, and then as I get up into this area, I'm down.
Yeah.
So as I go here, I don't want to move there. See, now I move my upper body and I held the knee. I want the knee to go first.
It's almost just like a button you're clicking.
I'm clicking there, and once I get to here, see, now I'm in kind of like a squat where my knees are apart.
Okay.
Now I'm coming through. You've done the basketball drill with your knees.
Yeah. Yeah, Monty, that's one of his big ones, where you let the basketball go. Well, you have it here.
See, here's the problem.
When I had the shanks, 2 years ago, Monty gave that to me.
Here's my reason why I don't like that.
Okay.
I mean, I don't like it. Because if you're going back, you got to have pressure inward to hold it.
Yeah.
You're better off having an elastic band go around your legs. What you're really trying to do is keep space.
Mm-hmm.
And when you put the basketball there, the knees are now going inward. You want the knees to go outward.
But we want the pressure on the insides of our feet.
No, I want the pressure. I
wouldn't want people to get like this, right?
I want to feel like this knee is above the ankle. I don't want to feel my knees in this way. I want to feel them like they're like it's a box.
Yeah.
Now when I turn back, see, I've got pressure going this way.
Yeah.
You feel?
Yeah. Two.
Now you've got pressure. Now when you get up to here, as you start to throw, I guarantee you this: you don't throw from here.
Mm-hmm.
There's no way in this planet you're going to throw here.
No, I mean, we can see. If I was going to throw
here,
this
you
ball.
Do, you do, here, come on, step on there.
If I was going to throw this ball, I would go, like, you know, we were just doing here, I go.
And then, okay, now keep throw. Your feet. Now step in there like you're going to have a golf posture. Now go back to the top. Now throw. That's all you need to do in your downswing.
Yeah.
You don't need to do any more there. And all you did there was put pressure into that foot.
Yeah.
That's where the sequence has got to start.
But I didn't consciously do it. I was just like, I'm going to throw this. Yeah, right. And that's where I'd like to get to with my golf swing, you know what I mean?
Well, I understand that. I mean, so I'd put it on the outside of my foot if you're going to put it anywhere.
Like there?
Yeah. So you're going back. Now throw.
Okay, I'm just going to throw. Oh, man, Lee, I hit that good.
But see, what you're doing is...
Have you ever seen a person hit a golf shot that good?
No.
Doubt it.
No.
Okay.
Yeah. What you're doing is this. You're up here, and because you're throwing, you've got this moving down. You don't have it moving out like you feel because you're throwing.
Right.
There's my pressure. There I'm going through the ball.
Well, that was the thing that we were debating about or talking about on the phone as far as... Let me give you this analogy to you. If I'm a terrible driver, like I drive a car horrible, and I go for a driving lesson, and somebody talks for an hour and a half about how a car engine works, you know, the gas goes in here, this, he's told me all about that. I can leave that session being a worse or no better driver.
You're not doing anything about driving a car. It's like
exactly.
Being a race.
That's my problem with a lot of golf instruction.
It's like being a mechanic as opposed to a... Formula One driver.
Yeah.
You've got to, so what you've got to do is find out what works for you. You've got to find out, and that's why I say there's not one way to do this. I think what happens with you sometimes, but I know you need to get internal thinking about what you're doing with respect to how this is starting, because you don't want to start there.
Yeah.
And to me, when you're starting here, the baseball drills, the step drills, the drills that we're doing, I'll talk about sequencing.
Yeah, well, sequence, I think, for
but
once you're below a 10 handicap or so, is probably the most important thing.
But I'm not so sure
better.
It's important for everybody else. If you're going like this, you need to let it feel like you're going to throw from the ground.
It's probably the most important thing. But that's why I think a lot of people in the comment section of these videos, they say, oh, you're doing this, you're doing that, you're doing this. I think there's a huge difference. One pro said to me that I was confusing what happens with what to do. And I'm really, at this point, interested in what to do. I have a pretty good idea through the models and through some slow motion stuff what actually happens. I know that the lower body goes first. I know that all this other stuff happens. But what do you do, though, you know,
see,
to make
me,
that good stuff happen?
To me, I would go in. To me, it's more, let's throw the ball. Let's move.
Yes.
Let's move the pressure from the right foot to the left foot and keep the center of mass the same. The center of pressure is shifting. There's your motion.
I just want to, yeah, right now I'm just thinking about throwing, which
but
is...
Well, that's okay.
Yeah.
You want to get up to here and just throw at the ball. But see, so mm-hmm. you want to feel underhanded and sidearm, correct?
Yes.
You understand
yeah.
underhanded
uh-huh.
sidearm. Hey,
that's not it. Yeah.
That's not underhanded and sidearm. So underhand and sidearm, underhand is like this. Sidearm means I'm coming down laterally.
Yeah, this is more like if I was trying to throw a lawn dart into the ground over there, I go...
Yeah,
like that, you know,
that's
but,
not underhanded
no.
sidearm.
Underarm and sidearm would be...
Yeah, but it almost will come out this way.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, in my younger days, what I would do, idiotically, mm-hmm. is I would stand on a bag stand. I'd put a 9-iron here, step on it.
Uh-huh.
I'd go up to here and I'd throw the ball there. When it does that, when you do this standing on the ground, the ball ricochets off at 45 degrees. But if you had a hole there in the plexiglass, mm-hmm. if you were standing,
mm-hmm.
you could throw it right through that hole because it's moving in that direction.
Yep.
That would be your motion here.
Mm-hmm.
See, I think people.
But you wouldn't want to throw straight. You like at a 45.
Now I'm going to feel. Well, when I get up here, where am I at? Here's my line.
Mm-hmm.
This is coming like that. So it's got to go. Like I said to you, it's got to go at a 45. It feels like it's going at a 45, but when you go here, you get it coming down at zero.
Well, that was one of the things that Lee and I were talking about. Lee gave me the absolute, bar none, best golf tip I've ever gotten in my life, which was...
Back to target?
No, which was on YouTube, you can hit the comma and the period button, I'll put that up, and actually go frame by frame on YouTube. I'm a professional YouTuber. I had no idea. So I'll put the actual symbols of what to do on this video. But we were watching, Lee and I were watching...
Schwartzel.
Charles Schwartzel. And the big difference we saw in Charles and me is at six, if you guys know.
Well, it's five. Well,
actually,
six five. And five. It was
at five, I was about 5 degrees in, and Charles was
about like that. It's about like that.
So one thing we were talking, tell me that thing that I think Cotton was saying about the left arm.
Okay, no, go back and take your setup.
Okay.
This is a Harry Vardon deal. It was, I think, Joe Norwood. It was in Joe Norwood's book.
Uh-huh.
Joe would say that whenever they first film Harry Vardon's swing, is this is an angle about 45. So go to the top of your backswing. That Vardon felt as if he was starting the club down this way. At a 45, he was going to hit a stake back there behind him. Mm-hmm.
And he felt that so much that he was shocked when he saw the film of it?
Exactly.
Okay.
He was shocked when he did it. But here's the deal. This is at 45. That's your angle. Now, what you do is you move here, mm-hmm. and now you've got the club. It started to move over. The club is right. outside there. The balance mm-hmm. point of the club, which is here, is outside your hands. Mm-hmm. It's releasing.
And then
so
I
what
gotta...
I want you to feel, I wanted you to feel, is I wanted you to feel this come down this way.
Okay. Yeah.
But again, you're coordinating that with the
yes.
Happy Gilmore
right.
plant.
Yeah. Oh, but with the plant, so I'm...
Now, and then go through. Don't
it, yeah.
no, just now. Now do that. Start down like that. Now, go all the way through. I want you to go all the way through. Now, do it again without the pause. So you're going back. Now, when you go back and edit this, play that back in slow motion and see where it is. Because I'm uh-huh. pretty sure you're going to see that club coming down the plane like we talked about here. That if this is, it's not coming at 45 uh-huh. because your body's opening up, but because you started this arm down.
Yeah.
Everything is coming down where you want it to go.
Well, I've always had a world-class practice swing. If I've
you
I'd always
take
done
that
my
into
practice
here.
Swing to actual to the ball, that's been a big difference.
Wait a sec. Say that again.
My practice swing has always done everything I want my real swing to do.
Okay.
But over the ball, I don't know, anxiety or especially off of
okay,
a bare lie,
okay, here's
it
the
gets
target.
Worse and
here's
worse.
Here's the
yeah.
target. Peter Croker, in his thing, had two targets for golf.
Uh-huh.
The club heads targets the ball.
Mm-hmm.
The ball's target is out there.
Yeah. Yeah.
So when you're up here at the top of your backswing, your attention is to hit the ball.
Yeah.
And the ball's target is the flag or the spot in the fairway.
Yeah, like a combo shot in pool or something.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah.
You're getting too much. I want to see there instead of feeling like when you threw the ball, when you threw the ball, it's perfect. When you got up to here and then threw it at that motion, your body reacted.
Well, everything is at getting it there. Yeah.
You made the athletic motion you've got in your pivot. You got the club going here. Okay, now it's coming down into there. So it's not going this way first.
Yeah.
You're starting here. There's your Happy Gilmore and then go. And once you get that pressure there, you're pushing up off it.
And with this Varden drill, it's amazing how behind you it feels and how.
But it doesn't.
But then, on video, it's not, So just try to throw this from that.
That's good too.
That was great, that one.
That's really good.
Yeah.
But I kind of got to get you out of your own way, if you understand what I mean.
I wonder why I would be so have so many golf lots in my
for the same reason I do.
Okay, guys.
Because you're going to see everybody.
Yeah, right. You guys can find out more about Lee where, Lee? How can people contact you? Email is good, right?
Email is good. My email is ldeit163@gmail.com.
Which is here in the title or in the description. And Lee teaches lessons two times a week, three times a week.
Yeah. I teach here on Mondays at Duarte, usually around 10 or 11 in the morning, and then I teach Thursdays at Midhill Driving Range in Corona, or East Valle, actually, in the afternoon, and then Saturday mornings at East Valle.
Yep.
And Wednesday, I'm at Temecula all day long with the Golf College.
Everything you need to know about Be Better Golf is at bebettergolf.net. See you guys later. Hit the like button and the subscribe button. Bye. You have time for one more thing, Lee?
Yeah. Okay. I want to show you a driver.
Yeah, well, that's what we're pulling out now.